Let's see how she gets this fixed. Missing from my usual setup, but I don't have as much of my upset stuff on this time. It's because we're on the test server. We're on Sissy. We're going to be playing around with some pretty random stuff.
Hello.
I don't know exactly what's going to happen.
Hi.
Look out on Sissy.
Cool. Test server, for goodness.
I suppose I should click on good old Callie over here, shouldn't I?
Yes, you should log in.
This is my first trip over to the test server. Oh.
Oh my god, my multi-twitch command still works too. Sweet.
And Aura's popped up.
Everybody's favourite little AI.
It doesn't help that I'm re-listening to The Learning Cliff, so I'm getting all of the hatred towards Aura again. Dismiss Aura. Go away.
It's like Aura. Bugger off. We do not want you.
And I am in a Tristan again.
Yay, get all the little Tristans.
Oh, and it's Tristy too! Oh.
Tristy 2 doesn't exist anymore on TG, does it?
No.
Well, here you go. That's one thing that you could start off with. You could give people an update on what you've done since the last time you streamed.
Oh, yes. So last time we streamed, we went wormhole diving, didn't we?
Yeah.
And was I flying Cathy then?
No, you still had Tristan then.
Okay.
I think I told you not to bring the catalyst.
Okay. Yeah, so since then I've joined my first non-NPC corp. So now I feel like a real Eve player, not just somebody who's faking everything. And I think I'm now up to Tristy 3. I may have lost Tristy 2 at some point, and I've definitely lost a catalyst since then.
So you're still not doing too bad, are you?
No. No. But, so, just to dive in with my first question, since we've already talked about, well, mentioned that I am now in a non-NPC corp.
Yep.
And that question is somewhere on my list.
How many pages have you got for me this time?
5 and a bit.
Oh, God.
So, now that I'm out of an NPC corp, does this mean we can no longer be friends?
No.
I like the hesitation in your voice there.
I had to kind of, like, my brain was catching up with the question. Well, the current corp and the lines I'm in, we like everybody, apart from Red. And you're not Red to us, so we won't shoot you.
Good. I don't really like being shot.
I'm not going to say what I was going to say, because it's terrible. I was going to say you've got plenty of experience of that already.
That was mean. And uncalled for.
War targets are not your friend. War targets are definitely not your friend.
So I need to find my way to you, don't I?
You do.
I wonder, first of all, there's the button I'm looking for. Do I want to join your fleet? Do I really? I suppose.
usually in your best interests.
Every now and again. Right. I am going to take a detour via Dodixie so I can get a catalyst.
You can just buy one from the station here.
Oh yeah, of course.
Welcome to the Joys of the Tesla. Everything is 100 disc, and you can get almost anything vaguely anywhere, I guess?
Wait, does this mean I can get an Astero?
Yes, you can get an Astero.
Today might be the greatest day of my life.
Oh god. Does this mean I have to teach you how to probe scan properly as well?
Yes.
Oh, but wait! You can manage that, surely.
Okay, so I've got the regional market window open, mm-hmm. and in this current system, there is an Astero for 100 disc. One system over, there's an Astero for 62 million.
Yeah, it's called players having fun with the market.
Well, they should stop that.
Just forces you to pay attention, it's
fine. And it's not currently in this station, so and now I need to go outside. In game, obviously, I'm not actually going to go out into the real world. That would be silly.
Cool. I've just been typing away things, by the way. Vaguely listening.
Thanks.
You had a question, so you still haven't actually asked a question yet.
I have technically asked a question.
I suppose
I should probably start on this list.
Yes. You should also get your ass over here.
I'm picking up my Astero.
But
I suppose I could have, I guess, made
There's
my way.
There's like 99,000 of them here.
Well, okay. I like this new docking animation.
It's cool, isn't it?
I think it would start getting annoying after, like, the fifth time.
Look as it swoops in. Now, I've got a bit of a range of different size ships. So I've got a rookie ship. I've got a cruiser. I've got a battleship. And a dreadnought.
What shall I name this Astero?
Anything you like.
I don't want to go with...
what you should name.
Don't think there's enough characters for it.
Ah, yeah.
Yes, there is.
The bigger ships you don't get the docking animation for, which I read somewhere, so that's fine.
Right. What was the command to see where I can teleport to? Slash
in the
move
local
me.
Channel, slash move me.
Six taxi Z?
Yep.
You cannot do that while in docking. Oh, I am suddenly with you. Well, I'm warping somewhere.
Yeah, it'll do the same thing you do if you do like a log off in space, or if you get disconnected, it'll kind of just walk you to deep space somewhere.
Right.
Then you can just go to the station.
I'm guessing the only station?
I think so.
Moon 6.
Moon 6, the Intaki Syndicate Station.
So, first proper question.
Okay.
And we did briefly discuss this earlier today, actually. So, as you are very well aware, and I guess some people who are watching might also be aware, I have a kill right out on you, because you accidentally killed me. And unfortunately, I don't think we're going to have time between it expire. Oh, I meant to check when it expires. Wait, I can do that now. I'm an idiot.
Yes, you can.
I'm an actual idiot.
See, on my screen it says 5 days, 20 hours, 32 minutes remaining.
Yeah. Yeah, that's about right, actually. So, we're probably not going to have time within the next 5 days and 20 hours and 32 minutes for me to come out and kill you. Mm-hmm. So what happens when this inevitably expires?
It just expires.
So you don't get anything for surviving a kill, right?
Nope. I just didn't die.
See, I think somebody... I think, you know, you should be rewarded for not dying.
Well, it's more a case of I did something mean to you, and you either chose not to take revenge or you were incapable of taking revenge for various reasons. So it's more the fact I basically got away with it.
Hmm.
No.
Wait, can I kill you on this server?
Yes, you can.
Hmm. You know what my next question's going to be, don't you?
Want to kill me and activate the kill right and get it over and done with on Sissy? Feel free.
I think we'll leave that till the end.
Yes, this is the one time where I am happy to die as many, many times as as happens, really.
Yeah. And I'm guessing deaths on here don't get logged on Z-Killboard or anything.
No.
So it's like they never happened.
Yep. I'm quite impressed. I'm, like, slightly ship-spinning in an Aneris now, because this is the one I brought to the test server yesterday. Ooh. I apparently took some hull damage.
Oh, that's the one that looks like a original Cylon.
I'm going to go with yes.
The front view. I have an
Estelle.
It still
costs you a ton to repair your ship, though. That sucks. Oh, and I just watched all my damage heal up. That's so cool. Oh. So pretty. Right, you're here then, right?
Yes.
I say we undock and go sightseeing while you ask questions.
Okie doke. Undock. So you get a cool docking animation, but you don't get a cool undocking animation.
Yeah. Oh my god, have you seen how many wrecks there are outside this station?
Quite a few.
Naglfar.
Oh, the camera's a bit different on here, isn't it?
In the top battleship. What is that? It's a Vindicator right there. So, if you look on your overview, you should have some nice things on your overview that you've probably not seen before.
Not allowed to touch the yellow boxes.
Definitely do not touch the yellow boxes.
There's a supercarrier 126 kilometres away from me. I don't think I've seen a supercarrier before.
Really?
I probably have. I may have not been paying attention at the time.
Hold on, I need to sort out my view. This is rubbish. There we go.
That doesn't look that impressive. Oh, but...
What type of supercarrier is it?
It is...
Wyvern?
Yeah.
Or Wyvern, I guess I should say.
It's doing some cool animations there.
That is the Kaldari one. That is actually the one that the Valkyrie are based out of.
Hmm.
This one's got a nice skin on it though. I can't tell you what skin it is off the top of my head, but... yeah, it's a Wyvern. Which is pretty cool. I'm not a big fan of Kaldari ships, but I do like this one.
Ooh, there's a tactical destroyer.
I'm just gonna sort of way the things now.
It is remarkably flat.
The Hecate, I'm assuming.
Yes.
Yes. the Galante tactical destroyer. You know, I brought the Spiffle.
Yeah.
I think did it on stream last time. This is the Galente version. It doesn't really animate much when it goes into the different modes, but it's pretty cool. It's a really, really good missile platform. Really good. I think I own one. I've never flown it.
I can't get over how flat it is. It's like a pancake.
Oh, if you want a pancake, look at a bar guest. I might get your bar guest out later so you can have a look.
This camera is slightly different. This is quite disorienting.
Yeah, there's some interesting ships around here so far. It's a Claymore. I don't actually see Claymores that often. They're weird. These Minmatar ones at the front. If you just look at the front with the... oh my god. Heat sinks. There we go. The things that look like solar panels on the front, I believe, are actually heat sinks. If my vague knowledge of Minmatar ships / clear skies is anything to go on. So do you want to go see something properly shiny?
Yes, I'm just admiring a Nighthawk at the moment.
Yeah, not too bad.
Again, kind of flat.
So you can kind of already see some of the things in space anyway.
Yeah.
The warp is a bit closer to one. We've come in directly above it, which is weird. This is the smallest of the citadels.
What are all the dotted lines coming off of it?
Okay, treat this kind of like an international airport.
Okay.
So those are kind of the landing strip lights, if you will.
That's pretty cool.
It is. When I get a big ship out later, you'll get to see the tethering stuff as well. Because we're in subcap ships, we can dock at it, I think. Or we could do if this wasn't owned and they don't want anyone to dock in. But if you fly close to it, like I'm approaching it now, I'm 12 kilometres away from it and it is still huge and I am tiny. Like, I can't even see my ship. It is just... Oh, no. It's not targeted. There we go. But yeah, my ship is 7.5k away from it. And it is still huge and my ship is tiny.
This is so cool. Of course, because we're flying like directly down onto it, it does look like we're trying to bomb the place.
Bombing run! Get stealth bombers out, we could do that. Probably not. No. Let's not start a war on Sicily.
Yeah, that is not on my to-do list for today, I'm afraid.
No.
I've just realised I'm flying an unfit Astero.
That's fine. Oh, we can dock at it. Oh, docking request denied.
No.
They don't want us to have it. There is a test free port, though.
Is that not what... Oh, nope, that's the thing below. Okay. I just walked through, like, 5 different things.
So we should be able to dock at this one.
Oh, it was this that I was sort of aligning to and approaching.
See, what's really cool is when you get to dock at a citadel, you get the cloaking effect, which is pretty cool.
I'm currently tethered.
Tethered? You got the little line coming out?
Yeah.
Pretty good.
That's a nice looking line.
First time I went up to a citadel, I was in an Archon, which is a Mark carrier.
Yeah.
I didn't realise that it does it really fast. Oh my god, okay, duck and unduck. Duck and unduck? Dock and unduck. Jeez Louise, before I start drinking.
And so I was tethered at... Oh, wait, what am I going towards?
Did you right-click on the citadel and press dock?
Which one are you docked at?
The one that is a freeport.
Test freeport?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just undocked again and I'm now tethered. But if you dock and undock, as your ship comes out, as it's like flying towards the camera, look at what looks kind of like a USB port, basically.
My docking request has been denied.
Really? At the freeport?
The Keepstar?
No.
Oh. In that case, then, I'm clicking on something else called Test Freeport.
There should be one of every...
The Fortizar one.
No, the Astro House.
Oh, whoops. I'm...
That's why it was denied, because you're too far away. The Astro... Oh, I'm going to broadcast it. This. Dock at this.
Well, I'm docking at something.
This is going brilliantly. But yeah, just dock and undock and then look at the detailing as you're coming out, because you've got the green hologram signs that are just saying invulnerable. It's pretty good. Full on.
Are you reading the chat?
Yep.
I feel like I'm being insulted right now. Oh, that is pretty cool.
Isn't it? The detailing in this is just so cool.
I like the holographic signs just saying invulnerable.
Yeah. I like the fact that you can still move your ship and the tether kind of moves with your ship and it just tracks it.
This is so cool. At one point... At what point would I become untethered?
When you get far enough away from it. I don't actually know the tethering range.
Okay.
These are new territory to me too. But you've got these kind of billboards up here too that I'm just flying towards, kind of sort of towards E3V1 now. It's pretty cool. I'm heading towards the two spires. And this is of course painted in Upwell blue.
What spires are you flying towards?
The big sticky outy things at the top. Next to the elevators. With the elevators going up and down on them, which in themselves are just amazing. There's four elevators on the inside of each one. I think there's four. Well, there's four big ones and possibly lots of smaller ones, I'm not quite sure.
Oh, I'm looking at it side on. That's why it doesn't look like there's anything there.
Oh, these things are amazing. Oh, you can't fly through the spires. I have a feeling that would be the case. God damn it.
Wasn't that in one of the trailers, though, for the Citadel update?
Yes.
See, now I feel like that's a little bit of false advertising.
What is? Oh, you can fly through the middle, I don't know. Okay, I just randomly am now.
Okay, so it's not false advertising.
Oh man, those elevators! Oh my god, I love this. This is. I used to think pauses were big, and then we shot lots of them, and then I was like, okay, they're not quite so big anymore. And then looking at Citadels, it was kind of like, oh, they look pretty big. And then on the poster at FanFest, there was like a Titan next to a Citadel. The Titan was tiny. I was like, oh shit, these things are big. Then saw one firsthand up close. I went, oh dear god. So yeah, these things are pretty big, and this is the smallest one.
Oh, we were docked at different citadels.
Did you dock at the Test Fortizar?
Yes.
I'm about to head there, because I'm doing them in order.
I just figured out where I went wrong, and now you're taking me back there.
You know what we could have done? You could have just walked to me.
That's what I just did! And then you decided to warp away.
Well, I wanted to go see the Quarter Zone, and you'd already missed seeing the Astro Host, so... Oh, I'm already being tethered by it. Oh,
yep.
So good. Oh, yeah, these ones are different. Oh, this is where I have... I realise I don't have a prop on this ship. Sucks. I think I'm approaching this one upside down as well.
And that's how I eventually realised that we were in different places. Because I was sort of warping down to where you were. I'm like, but how? How?
Oh, this one is... this is the only one I haven't seen, actually. It's a Fortizar. This one looks more like a aircraft carrier. This one really does look a lot more like an aircraft carrier.
Directly in front of me, there's a green shiny orb. I can't click on it, so it's not really anything.
Oh, okay, I didn't see it, yeah.
And it flashes every few seconds.
I'm assuming it's just a light beacon for the Fortizar.
Yeah.
In fact, if you zoom out, you can see a ring of them. It's the kind of...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that might be the tethering range area, actually. Yeah, I don't like this one quite as much, actually.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool, but...
Are you ready for your next question?
Yeah, let's go for it.
So, there's a bit of a backstory to this question.
Okay.
One that you're very familiar with. It's just backstory for the audience. So, we recently experienced a slight hiccup when using a bowhead for a courier contract.
Oh, yeah, carry on.
In which I contracted... you to move a bunch of my stuff from one place to another because I could no longer get to where they were. Well, I could get there, but then I wouldn't have been able to leave, which would have defeated the object. And turns out that the freighter ship you were using, you can't do courier contracts in.
And for unfitted ships.
Yes.
If it's in a box. Or I haven't found a way around it yet.
Yeah. So...
Well, actually, no. That's not true. I can do it, but I have to break the container, which tells me I will fail the contract if I do.
Yes.
But then when I went to manually fail it, or something else like that, it said, are you sure you have all these ships? And I was like, I don't, because I gave them to you. I don't know. Sorry, carry on with the question. I got sidetracked a little bit.
Yeah, so my question basically was, should I have just outsourced it to someone with a different type of freighter?
Possibly. Or, because it was me, you could have just set it up as an item exchange. Because what the hell was I going to do with a bunch of Catalysts and Tristans?
There were other ships in there as well.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm about to go warp off to something else. A second. Because you know I said I wanted to go poke a Job Observatory and you said only on the test. Yeah. So, following on from the freighter story...
Mm-hmm.
Can you actually equip a freighter with a micro warp drive or an afterburner?
Yep.
How fast do they then go?
Still not very fast at all.
No. Is it actually worth equipping a freighter with something like that?
I don't actually know. I don't do a whole lot of freighting because I'm usually just moving my own stuff around, so I'm usually only moving one or two ships at a time.
Yeah.
I don't know. So if there's anyone who does freighting who's listening or watching, please let us know. Oh my lord.
Okay.
That is a clusterfuck of warp disruptor bubbles. That's like an artificial sun. Wow, okay. I was not expecting that. And again, I don't know. Your microphone is way sensitive.
Well, hopefully that'll get fixed tomorrow. With my nice new shiny one.
Oh, I stand corrected. Freighters can't be fitted with mid-slots. I don't actually use freighters. So. But no, you can't put a prop mod on it.
Fair enough. So basically you just lied to me is what you're admitting to right here.
My lack of knowledge. Yeah. So when I spin around to the other side of the horrendous ball of mighty doom, Jovian observatories do look pretty cool, even though this one's
tiny
and shattered.
Yeah. Which leads me on to my next question.
Okay.
See what I mean when I was talking about like segues
you
and everything?
This all planned out,
I
you?
Know. So, as I think just about everyone in the Western world at this point knows, the tagline for the film Alien is, "In space, no one can hear you scream."
Okay.
So what, if any, horrors await us in space? Is there anything truly horrific and terrifying and like deep space monstery kind of thing?
There's not a whole lot of kind of got various degrees of pirates, which are all humanoid. You've got the Jove, which are humanoid. You've got the Sleepers, which are humanoid. That's kind of it.
That's a little disappointing.
Well, think of how much death, chaos, and destruction
just humans
in this universe. I think we manage fine without any green monsters from another planet.
You'll be glad to know that is now one page of questions finished.
Good. Right. Do you know that keep star you were at before?
Yeah, the one that's currently being built.
Yep.
Yes.
Can you walk back to it?
No.
Oh, is it not on the overview?
Not on the overview.
Okay. I'm just going to bounce around so I can find it. Can you remember what it was called?
Test Freeport.
Okay. I did wonder.
The other two are on there, though.
Yeah, I can see four on there, so I'm just going to warp to one of them and hope the other one comes up somewhere. There's the one that's under construction. I'd quite like to get some screenshots of.
Cool.
Oh my god, I can hear myself completely now. That's really weird.
I'm just gonna walk to you.
Oh, now these are good. I do like the keep stars, I have to say.
Is it just me, or is the warp animation on here slightly more jittery?
Possibly, but the amount of stuff it's trying to load in this one system at the minute, I mean, you wouldn't usually have four keep stars a shed load of just water disruptor bubbles and two Astro Houses and a Fortizar in place at any one time.
Where are you?
I'm still bouncing around trying to find that other Keepstar.
Because you're not on my overview anymore.
No, because I've swapped away. I still can't find that other Keepstar. What on earth?
It's like I warp to you and then you warp away. It's like you're actively trying to run away from me. I don't even know what I did to deserve this.
Can I find the one I need? Probably not. I'm being repaired? I'm being tethered and I was being repaired at the same time by this Keepstar. What?
That's pretty cool.
That is very cool. Because these are like hoses. These have module slots.
Yeah.
So you can pretty much customize them to do what you want them to do. If you want them to be like for everything to do with ships and stuff, or if you want them to be like big defensive bastion fortresses and stuff, you can just fit them out how you want, which is pretty sweet.
Now I'm being tethered. Oh, those are the graphical issues you were on about.
Which ones?
It currently looks... I think back to the PS1, possibly PS2 era, in a third-person game when you tried to move the camera. It's a bit like that.
Yeah.
Although that nebula is pretty...
It is, isn't it? I was just staring at that. It's very, very nice. I still want to find this Keepstar that's in the middle of being built.
It was on top of the other two, wasn't it?
Well, I'm going to walk back to the first Astro House we're at. The Astro House we're at then. I should be able to see it, I'd have thought.
Oh, excuse me.
See, I can see the Astro House and the Fortizar, and I can't see the Keepstar.
Is it possible that it's just gone?
Ah, I found one that's anchoring. And again, this Astro House is trying to repair me at the same time. That was pretty cool. I didn't know they did that.
I appear to have lost you again.
Ah, oh, here we go. Ah, very, very nice. I'm going to turn my UI off now and do some screenshots.
There's two, or possibly one, citadel out in the distance called Trump Pleasure Center and Casino.
That's the one I'm at.
Fair enough.
That is the one that is currently under construction. I look so weird as they're being built, but pretty cool at the same time. Little weird little nanite things constructing it. So
that
cool.
Is so cool. Let's zoom out some.
I'm also being slightly magpie-ish in the fact that I've just seen some wrecks. I'm going to go loot them. could also see some... Ah, there's a wyvern over there, that's why. I was gonna say, I can see some fighters, but I can't see what's attached to it.
Ooh.
Oh, I've walked to a dead Loki.
No.
Who had warfare links on him? Mine now. Oh, quite pretty wreck. Except it's just a... okay, it's not as good as I thought. Okay, so we've seen these and we've vaguely seen a Jove Observatory.
Yeah.
Ah. Oh. Oh no, it is there. I was going to say, this isn't just a Loki, this is what looks to be a pile of Naglfars.
What?
Do you want to walk to me? This is, yeah.
What's a Naglfar?
It is the Minotaur Dreadnought.
Oh. Oh wow!
This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of them, wrecked in exactly the same place.
Huh.
Yeah, this is.
The wreck looks so cool.
See, this is why last time I was on Sissy. A group of us got together and undocked dreads and all the big kind of things. And just shot the hell out of each other for about 3 hours.
Nice.
So, I have lots of screenshots. I think the Moros is probably my favourite big ship when it's dead.
What's the keyboard shortcut to get rid of the UI again?
Control F9.
Aha. I thought it was F10. I then got very confused.
So if you stay there for a minute, I'm going to go change ship.
Okie doke. Okay, I just zoomed into the middle of the wreck.
Many wrecks. Many pieces of duct tape needed to fix that.
It kind of looks like it's running through with lava.
Kind of does, from the burn marks and
stuff. Yeah. Oh, the lighting in this game is just so, so on point. Do kind of feel a little bit like J.J. Abrams would have a field day with this lens flare, though.
Oh, lens flare everywhere.
What ship are you bringing out?
You'll see. One where I haven't actually loaded any ammo, apparently. There we go.
Are you about to shoot me?
No. I don't think I'd be able to with this thing anyway. Hello!
I can't see you.
I'm above you, I think.
Oh wow. So that's what one of these looks like when not blown up.
Yes, when in one piece. They are actually vertically flying ships. So I will write this really slow thing. Dreadnoughts are not designed to go fast. They're designed to do a shit ton of damage.
This is so cool.
Yeah. So, Naglfar. Yeah.
Yeah, I could never own one of those.
Why not?
I'd have to call it Nagly.
Naggy?
Nagly. And
why would you put the L on it too? One thing I do want to try though is I have no idea what that does. I've just put it into siege mode. Oh, there we go. There's the animation. Oh, that's cool. So my gun turrets have just, I think it's my gun turrets. One of them should be missing a gun, if so. Have all just slid forward.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, animation. I love the animation. So yeah, I also just noticed there's like a spinning orangey core thing. Now siege modules take ages to cycle, so I'm gonna come out of siege in like 2 or 3 minutes.
Okay.
And we'll get to see the animation change again. So feel free to ask more questions.
The next one is a two-parter.
Oh God. Okay.
And I didn't even think I could ask this with a straight face. I'm probably going to get the pronunciation completely wrong. So, the other day, I think it was you, probably, who informed me of the existence of creatures called Fedos?
Yep, Fedos or Fedos, however you want to say it.
Fedo. Where can I find one?
You can buy them on the market.
Oh my god. And what is an appropriate name for a Fido? Fidi?
You cannot name them.
Oh.
They are just a market commodity.
You got me really excited! And then just disappointment.
While my siege module's cycling, actually, I'm gonna see if I can find some of the other crazy stuff. That exists in E, that is purely MacGuffin. I'm really cool. So if you look in Fleet Chat...
Why is there a donut holder?
Why? Why is there not a donut holder?
I like how it has... a volume of 0.01 meters cubed. Those would be some pretty big donuts. No, pretty small donuts. Just donuts.
I'm trying to remember where it was, or the... all the really, really cool stuff like this. Now, without even having to click on that link, you should know what that is referring to. you're just giggling now.
Yeah. Because this is amazing. I can't believe it's someone's job to write the copy for these descriptions.
It's got to be one of the most fun jobs ever.
Okay, I've also got the market window open because, yes, I'm going to buy myself a Fido. But I'm a bit
We got given them at Christmas the year I started playing, actually.
That's a pretty cool Christmas present. But, so, everything on here costs 100 ESC, yeah?
Apart from special edition stuff. Which is why all the special edition assets are like 100 million.
Right. So I've got the buy Fido window open.
Mm-hmm.
And it says 100 ESC. Then it also says 9,900% above regional average.
Yeah.
If everyone is selling it at 100, how is 100? The price you've chosen is 9,900% above regional average. Are you sure you want to enter this order? Yes.
I'm just linking you a shed load of stuff, by the way.
I had noticed. I'm going to click through them all now. I'm just going to make this window a bit bigger. Concordoken.
Oh, yay! Okay, through your speakers as well as mine, I think. No, it was just mine. I just had my ship come out of siege. That is badass. They slid back, and the spinning orange thing in the middle is now covered over again. Oh, that's amazing.
I had a window in the way, so I didn't see anything.
I did as well, then I could hear things and just went, what? And then looked at my siege module and then looked at my ship and went, ah! I need to look at this.
What am I doing? So, a funny educational video created in YC-108 to teach pilots of New Eden about the powers of the Concorde Police
Force. Concorde Oaken! Yeah,
Kruber's modified strip miner.
Yes, Kruber is the only person who is allowed very big ships in HISEC. Very big ships, much like this one, are not allowed in HISEC. He's the only person that allowed it.
Last reminder to pay yourself, Bill.
Do you know the story behind that? I can't remember how much it tells you, actually.
Wasn't a war started because somebody forgot to pay?
Yes.
Yeah.
This was what caused the Battle of VTEC R5B, I think.
Premiere ticket for Clear Skies.
I love that they made that into an actual thing.
Rooks and Kings, the Clarion Call compilation.
Yes, again, if you have not watched the Rooks and Kings videos, I highly suggest you do, because they help. Really good.
I shall add that to my list.
Worth it. Well worth it.
Socks for space boots.
I think that is about CCP Fox 4, who is either leaving or has left CCP now, I believe. Dear Nullivore, stop stealing my shoes. It's not funny anymore. FF. Fox 4. Yes. He actually got his I can't remember if it was his socks or shoes stolen. I'm assuming it was his socks as well. He ends up with the nickname Socks 4, which he really, really hates. Especially if you remind him of it when he's drunk.
The damsel.
Because he actually pouts and sulks, it's hilarious.
So the next one on the list that you've linked me to is the damsel's drunk bodyguard.
There is a mission, I believe it's a level 3 mission, or you encounter it first at level 3, called Damsel in Distress.
Right.
It's one of my favourite missions. It's the one I've done probably the most. You have to go to a pleasure hub.
Ooh.
And rescue the damsel who got supposedly kidnapped by a guy called Krull. And this pleasure hub is pretty much exactly what you'd expect it to be. and the reason she got captured is because the bodyguard was drunk. Supposedly.
Oh, that's adorable.
You're looking at the friendship.
Yeah.
The best ship in New Eden. Yep. CCP Guard's personal tagline, the best ship is friendship. Have you seen the photos from FanFest when Guard was doing his presentation at the closing ceremony?
No.
And he came out on stage in a cardboard spaceship. I will go to my Flickr account and find it, because holy crap, that was amazing.
So what's the story behind this unit of lag?
You've not encountered tie-dye yet.
I have not.
Good, you don't want to. Tie-dye is horrendous. Okay, for anyone who's in the Twitch chat, there is a link. It might work in the in-game browser.
I've just clicked the Twitch chat.
I can't remember if Flickr's one of the ones that does or doesn't work in the in-game browser.
Oh, that is amazing!
Looks like it doesn't work. Yes, how cool was that?
Oh, we've got the same camera. I'm fairly sure I've said this before.
Probably. But yes, he made himself, with a bit of help, a friendship. And he literally came on stage going, fantastic. DTP God, such a showman, it's brilliant.
Ooh. So somebody's just shown up on my overview as red. Because they have a security status of below -5.
Ooh.
I'm going to look at them.
Okay, just don't sneeze in their general direction, they may not like it.
Alright, so let me look. They've walked away. That would be why I can't look at them. There's something that's greyed out on my overview. It's not clickable. And it's disappeared.
Not clickable.
Yeah, it's disappeared now.
Okay, I am just about to buy another new shiny ship to show you.
Oh, that's something I meant to check. Skills. I'm gonna buy a cruiser!
You totally can buy a cruiser. This is good.
What's the best Galente cruiser to buy?
I'm biased.
Something is affecting your warp.
Oh. I was thinking battle cruiser. Oh, Vexa!
Oh, of course! Oh, yeah. Is that...
If you want the baby version of the thing I was flying earlier, you can buy an Execura.
How would one spell that?
EXE. Just search for that, you'll be fine.
Yes. Bye. I'm just docking up now. And then I get my Fido!
I don't think I've heard anyone else apart from Tora be so happy about Fidos.
Just like this on record, despite the fact I can't officially rename it, he will be colloquially known as Fidi.
Considering what Fidos do, that's quite apt name.
Why am I so far away from this? I guess I can cross the Fido question off my list.
Probably.
Do you want some questions about wormholes?
Oh god, go on then.
I need to flick back to the start of my list now. So, for the wormholes, there are side effects of people using the wormholes, right?
Define side effects.
Well, the more people who use a particular wormhole, the quicker it becomes unstable.
Yes.
Are there any kind of side effects for the travellers?
Are you talking from a lore perspective now?
Yes.
As in for the people inside the ship?
Yes.
don't actually know. I guess only about the same as they get through going through a Stargate.
Right.
It's a pretty similar effect.
I'm guessing it must have a bit of a horrific effect on the human crew. Oh my god!
The ships have been built for it, though. Also, Captioneer, what do they care about human crew?
True. Just to excitedly interrupt. I don't know how I can interrupt this comment. Oh, they've walked away. Oh. But there was someone called Gaius Baltar, too.
Oh, God.
I think I'm going to need to start rewatching Galactica.
Again? Weren't you rewatching that when you lived here?
Yes, I rewatch it once a year.
Okay.
I've not started my 2016 rewatch. Mostly because I'm trying to rewatch all of Orange Is the New Black before Friday. Yeah, that's not going to happen.
I'm now having a mental blank about some of the ships I'm looking to buy.
I really need to fit a micro warp drive onto this ship because, oh my gosh, this is slow.
Yes. Welcome to my world. Micro warp drives on everything if I could, if it was viable.
I did have another wormhole question. Oh yes. Are there any limits to how many wormholes can exist at a time?
Yes, I believe there is.
Okay.
Just because it's the limit that the servers can cope with.
Yeah, so obviously there is a server limitation, but is there a lore reason?
Probably because... I'd need to check up on this, but there's probably something about they can only generate in areas of space that have the correct conditions.
Okay.
I think it's been a while since I properly looked into the wormhole lore. I'll need to get my copy of Source out and see if it's in there.
Oh, such a shame. You're going to have to look at an Eve book.
My special edition copy as well.
Just to jump back to what's currently being said in the chat. QD, are you on about Galactica with that question? Because if so, I'm going to have words with you. Like, serious words. Mind you, today I was told by about 15 different people how wrong I am because I don't like Nintendo.
That's not wrong, that's just difference of opinion.
Yeah. You do realise that over a year ago when we worked together, there was a Skype chat titled Wrong, and it was just surrounded around me and my apparently incorrect opinions.
That somehow does not surprise me, knowing some of the other people at that place.
Yeah. Fairly sure there was another wormhole question as well. Oh yeah, can players create wormholes themselves?
No. They are naturally occurring phenomena.
I'd like to create a wormhole, just to cause shenanigans.
Huge transpatial event. Big bad event.
Imagine though if somebody could create wormholes like warp bubbles could be created.
What, just have a wormhole generator?
Yeah, so like, oh, you see a massive fleet coming towards you, oh, you can't be bothered to deal with them. So you just open up a wormhole right in front of them.
Jeez.
That would be cool.
I'm gonna undock. Because I want
to. I've only just docked. I am. Right, I am going to make this. I can't pronounce that.
Execura?
Yes, that one. I'm going to make that active. Going to rename it to Exy. And I'm going to put the Fido on it. So one of my questions, I guess I've already accidentally answered.
Mm-hmm, which was?
What will happen if I prod a Job observatory? The answer is nothing, because I just flew right through it.
But you didn't try and poke at it, like you didn't lock it up, you didn't shoot it, you didn't try and entosis it, or anything.
Okay, I'm going to equip some guns and I'm going to go back there and then just shoot it.
Okay, I'm gonna sit here. Well, when you undock, just fly over to where I am first.
Okie doke. What guns does this ship take?
Rail guns or blasters.
Okay.
But a Vexa is technically a. If you're in a Vexa? Or no, an Execura.
Yeah.
Either works on Execura, really. I tend to put rail guns on because I like range.
Any particular type of rail guns?
Gauss cannons? Whatever the Gauss ones are, I guess, maybe?
How many can be fitted?
I believe...
Three.
Four? Oh, three. I'm used to the Adiris.
Yeah, guns go in high slots, don't they?
Yes,
they do. Yeah, then three.
Oh, I've got a micro jump drive on this ship, ha ha ha.
I need a micro warp drive. Oh. What are micro warp drives called?
5mn micro warp drive or cold gas enduring micro warp drive? Compact micro warp drive.
Is micro warp one word?
Yep.
That would be why. This search functionality is, like, the worst.
It's just very specific. Considering how many items are in the database, it's not too terrible.
What else do I need? Ammo would probably help.
It would.
Shell info. You can use a lot of different ammo with these guns.
I'm being locked up by a rattlesnake.
I'm guessing not an actual rattlesnake because we're in space.
No, but this rattlesnake is deciding to yellow box me. Hello. He appears to possibly have a Tengu with him.
Oh, crap. Just realised. For ammo, it's actually more expensive to buy it here than it is on Tranquility.
Yeah. Everything's 100 S.
I don't really need anything more than guns and thingy, do I?
Not really. Yeah.
Also, what? I just accidentally opened up the FPS monitor instead of the fitting window. 104 frames per second.
Not bad. He docks up though.
Yeah.
This rattlesnake is slowly trundling towards me.
I'm going to undock.
I kind of want to see what he's going to do. Whether he's going to shoot me or not. I have zero tank on this. I didn't really fit it properly.
I'm gonna approach you. And I'm gonna use my nicely shiny
microphone. Is he inviting me to a conversation?
Interesting.
Okay.
I'm not just going to orbit you instead. Where is... right, so there's you. Where's this thing?
Where's what thing? The thing that's yellow boxing, right?
Yeah, is that the Moros?
Oh, there's a Moros?
Yeah, above you.
No, it's a rattlesnake, so it's Mr. Bison.
Uh-huh.
Having a nice conversation with the...
It looks like a scorpion!
Yeah. It's a pirate faction battleship.
Ah. Scramble attempt.
Ah, okay. Ah. Feel free to lock up the Moros and shoot.
Can I take on a dreadnought?
Nope. But you are faster and smaller, so he will have trouble tracking you. He is shooting me. I'm doing quite a lot of damage to him, actually, considering I'm also a gun missing. Several guns missing.
Where am I? Oh, I'm that thing that's tiny compared to everything else. Apparently, I'm actually helping shoot him.
Very nice. I've been neutered. That's not very fair. Oh, now the rattlesnake's joined in. Cool. And my bastion module is deployed and it's just about to jump back in.
How has nobody cottoned on to shooting me yet? Oh, I'm being scrammed and shot at. And webbed.
Yeah. Let's see if this fires before I die. It does. Excellent.
Why?
Try and hit me at 100k, people!
Wait, I thought PvP was supposed to be consensual here.
This is a free fire system.
Oh. I'm probably about to die.
Oh, my very burnt up paladin. Holy crap, this is pretty.
I'm dead.
Who killed you?
Asher had the final blow.
The guy in the Moros. Asher's a troll, but a lovely troll.
You know what I joked earlier that you were setting me up for my death.
Okay. Totally not intentional. I do know Asher.
Yeah, I'm kind of reading the chat at the same time.
Bless him. See, this is the kind of fun stuff you can get up to pretty safely on Sissy.
Why am I not docking? But I just spent, like, over a million-esque. That's horrible. The docking animation in the pod is horrific.
Really?
Yeah, it's juttery as hell.
Oh man, there's my severely burnt paladin limps back into the station. In fact, do you want to see how damaged it is? This is just armor damage as well.
Yes,
don't
please.
Don't get ticked into hull. I will undock again. And I will sit on the station undock and you can see how.
Okay. I'm undocking in a pod. Oh wow!
Yes, this is damage effects. I just love the damage effects. This is just armor damage.
That is beautiful.
I did not tick into structure. Structure damage gets a lot more fiery. And I think, I'm not sure if smoke still starts coming out of your engines or not.
That is so
pretty. How cool
is this? Oh, that is really annoying.
What?
I just accidentally ducked up because of the radial menu. So what? Oh yeah. So I'm gonna rebuy all that again and go shoot a Jove Observatory.
Cool.
Is there a way to quick buy things you've previously bought?
You can, from your
transactions?
Bleh, sentences. Combat log. If you bring up the ship you just lost, you can save the fitting, and then from the fitting stuff, you can buy, just basically rebuy the entire thing, the ship and everything.
I'm just going through my transactions. This is quite a long way of doing it. Oh well.
I'd better actually repair this paladin.
One day I'll stop.
15 million isk!
You might as well just buy a new one!
Yeah, I probably would actually. I'm just gonna leave this battle scarred.
Inventory. Assemble. Make active. Oh, first of all, change name to XE2. I am undocking. What's not fair?
Oh, look at what I've just undocked in. So the ship I was just in was a paladin, which is a marauder. It's the Amarian marauder. Ashton wants to bring out Vargo, which is the Minmatar marauder. He was just shooting my marauder with a dreadnought. I think it's about time I returned the favour.
I think that's only fair.
Just waiting to see his little name undock. It's not going to happen, is it? Are you going to go poke that Jove Observatory?
Yes. Currently warping to it now. Oh my god, it takes forever to lock it up. 150 seconds. Wait, that's 3 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Well, two and a bit.
Oh, yeah. Which I think just means it's time for the next question.
Go for it. You do that, I'm going to shoot the hell out of Asher.
So, why do implants destroy on clone activation? Aside from the technical limitations, of course.
Why do implants destroy it? Because the physical body you're in is where the implants are installed into. And it is your physical body that is being destroyed.
So, you mean to tell me that in this super futuristic, super intelligent era of time, people have not developed software implants? They're all just hardware.
Pretty much. Well, they're kind of... They're neural enhancements, really. So it's a physical thing that is stimulating areas of the brain.
Mm.
So it probably is doing something kind of along the lines of neurochemical production.
Yeah, I suppose. I'll accept that answer. Well, there's not really much I can do other than accept the answer, is there?
Not really.
No. So, sort of related, but not at all related. Mechanically, it's related. Why do ship rigs get destroyed when you unfit them?
Because I always think of ship rigs are kind of like internal wiring, so they're kind of things that's put throughout your ship to boost something that's done to your ship.
Okay.
So it's kind of to make your engines perform better. So it's kind of like tune-up stuff. And once you take it out, you can't really refit it because it's been custom done for that ship, I guess. Is the only way I think about it. How close it is, I don't know. Oh, I'm about to blow up a Moros.
I finally have the Gem Observatory locked. And I'm going to start shooting it!
Cool. I'm going to stop shooting this Moros before I blow it up. Is it invulnerable?
Yeah. Zero damage.
Warp to me very quickly. If you can.
On my way.
So once I've reloaded ammo and you are here, I'm gonna blow up a dreadnought. Okay, so you can see Asher in the Asher's Moros, right?
If I... Oh my god, stop warping! It's not letting me look... it's not letting me look at it, but yeah, I'm manually looking at it.
It's slowly turning to face me. And it's inevitable doom.
I feel so tiny.
I knew we could have got a Titan here.
Your animation is really cool, by the way, though.
My guns are missing just then, though. Oh, now they're hitting. Yeah, I'm in siege mode as well. So doing more damage.
You know what, like... So, you're not that much taller than me in real life, so you can probably relate to what I'm about to say.
Mm-hmm.
You know when you have, like, a super tall friend, and then you just, like, stood next to them, feeling kind of short and stupid? This is how I feel in my ship compared to you right now.
Okay, right. If you look at the Moros, you can see all the lights flickering. and they're flickering more and more the closer he is to exploding.
Yeah. This is so cool.
That, I haven't got my overview up at the minute, so I can't see how much hull structure he's on. What structure he's on.
Wait, if I
lock him up.
Yeah. Oh wow, you're like one hit away from killing him.
Oh yeah, his lights are pretty much out. I love how that's... Even with no HUD, I can tell that I've almost killed him because his ship is visibly failing. Oh my god, it's taking forever.
No, I just started...
Shooting?
Yeah!
Kaboom! And there you go, there is the wreck of a Moros.
Who got the... Oh, you probably got the final blade, didn't you?
Which is being fractured in? What?
Hmm?
Oh my god, a mobile tractor is tractoring in the Moros wreck! That's brilliant! Oh, I'm in siege, I can't... Oh my god, that is hilarious.
I'm kind of tempted to shoot the capsule. But that would be a bit of a dick move, wouldn't it?
Yeah. I just looking and go, why is the Moros moving? It's dead. And then looks sort of beam coming from it. I was like, someone's salvaging it or tractoring it. Oh, and I missed my siege module timer, so I'm just stuck here for another couple of minutes again. Oh, this is hilarious watching Dreadnought Wreck get tracked in by a mobile tractor unit. Although, this does explain why all those Naglfars are in the exact same place. There was a mobile tractor unit in the middle of it, tracturing all of the wrecks into the right thing.
What does a mobile tractor unit do?
Exactly what it says on the tin.
Okay, let me rephrase that. What's tractoring?
So, it's the same thing it is in most space things, is a tractor beam latches onto something and draws it towards it. So, it's... I told you about MTUs when we were doing missions, right?
I vaguely remember, yeah.
The effective way to do it is to warp into a mission site, drop an MTU, orbit the MTU, launch drones, lazy mission running, yay! I wanted to get a screenshot of that Moros wreck and now it's just joined all the Naglfars.
No.
That's pretty cool. He's got a Moros head sticking out of it. It's pretty cool. Oh, I've still got half my siege time left.
Can this ship launch probes?
I don't think you can fit a probe launcher on Exacura. I may be wrong.
In
you
that,
try it.
I'll just grab the Estero because I got to dock up anyway. Because you know what I'm about to try and do, right?
Do you want to probe something down?
I want to see if I can find a wormhole. There's probably not a wormhole, but you know.
There are two cosmic signatures in here, so you can go for it.
Which is why I thought, let's do this, and probably epically fail at it.
Well, I will... I think I can rebuild one of my old Stratioses, actually. And join you.
Can... No. So... The... Estero is a drone ship, isn't it?
Yeah. It gets bonuses to drones, I believe. But the Stratios definitely does.
How many drones can the Estero hold?
How many what?
Drones. Hobgoblins.
An Estero can... I want to say three. It's either 3 or 5 in another story. Off the top of my head, I can't remember the drone boundary. Or drone hold of space.
Boy and scanner probe. How many scanner probes do I want?
How many probes? 8.
Yeah, 8. Excellent.
I keep staring at things and remembering how the ships looked before the shader upgrades, and wow, it is a massive difference.
Is there a way to unfit something from a ship without making it active?
Yes, you can just click and drag it off into your item hanger.
How?
Oh, do you mean when you're in space?
No.
You can click and drag it.
Wait, I'm confused. So basically, I want to take the micro warp drive out of Exe and put it into the Astero.
You have to make the ship active. To unfit it.
So much effort. Unfit. Make the Astero active. Okay. I'm going to undock.
Ah, that red Tengu's back.
Oh yeah, so it is. Something's being shot.
Yeah, that'd be me.
Oh. What are you being shot by?
Varga.
Ah.
Ah, he's just gone into Bastion mode for me. That's gorgeous. Although I still don't really get why Bastion mode on a Varga is we're going to cover the heat sinks over. I don't really quite get it, but I love the Varga anyway as a ship. It looks pretty cool. The cool thing is he's draining my cap. I'm in a ship that doesn't use cap.
What I'm being shot at?
Who by?
Someone who isn't in our thing, and I'm being warped. Not warped, warped and scrammed.
Dock up if you can.
I can't.
You have a micro warp drive?
Yep.
Burn towards the station.
Doing so. One hit away from. Yep.
Who killed you?
Someone named Eric Christos.
Oh, in a VNI, okay.
Thanks, Dick.
Welcome to the test server. I'm also being locked up by a Thanatos. That's gonna be fun.
Can you do me a favour and shoot me?
Shoot you?
Yeah. Yeah, because it's gonna take forever to. Oh no, it's going kind of quick now. Sort of. Ish.
I won't shoot you.
He's warped out. Can't really. I would like to get revenge. He's no longer around.
I'm more curious about this Thanatos that's locked me up.
I can't believe I just spent like 3 minutes fitting out an Astera just for me to lose it instantly.
That happens quite a lot in Eve. Especially in this system. Now I'm being jammed by a widow. Sure. Okay.
Is there anything protective I can put on this ship? So that what just happens doesn't happen again.
You're always going to lose against the Vexor Navy unless you can speed tank him, and obviously he had the drop on you, so...
Yeah. But it's because I had the probe launcher window open.
Ah, yeah. That's always found that a difficult thing to try and juggle when I'm scanning. I still do it now in NullSec. I'm kind of like, oh god, I need to be looking at local, I need to be looking at D-scan.
I was going to fit a Kovops cloak, but I don't have enough remaining CPU to fit it.
Aww.
Still going to buy one anyway.
I do love Kovops cloaks.
Rename.
Oh, watching a Stratios, enter through the docking thing, it's pretty cool.
Right. If I want the Kovops cloak, I'm going to have to get rid of my gun. Oh well. Just going to buy some drones instead. Okay, weird camera stuff again.
Yeah?
Yeah. Nope, still happening.
I take it you've undocked.
Yeah. Oh, the camera trick isn't fixing the camera. Boo. I'm gonna have to dock back up again.
I'm gonna warp somewhere and cloak up, so no one will try and kill me. When you undock, if you want to warp to me,
will do.
Then probably a little bit safer.
Huh. Cameras happen. Huh. Well, okay. Think there's a bug with the Asterium.
How so? Is there a bug?
The camera thing's happened again. It just seems to be on. One seems to be on first click after undocking. So I can't move the camera. The first person camera is actually responding now. But if I. Aha!
I'm shooting the rats, don't worry. If you have drones and you want to launch them, feel free.
That's what I've just done.
Cool. They're all yellow boxing me at the moment, so you should be pretty safe. I also have a remote armor repair on this ship, so I can repair you.
Your targeting attempt fails because your ship is cloaked.
Ah, fun times. Oh, I'd forgotten how much I love doing this. Just going, yep, drones, you go
on. Oh, all of my drones have been killed.
Oh.
Wait, how many drones do you have out?
5.
Okay, because I'm seeing 10.
5 are yours then.
But apparently I have 0 drones in local space.
Try... What? That's weird, let me just see if I can see drones. Oh, there's a gecko!
What's a gecko?
It's a special edition drone that absolutely wrecks face. They are still worth several hundred million each on Tiki.
Right. They're all my... So the ones that are still are all my drones, but...
Is it... Really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because I can see some Hobgoblin ones. If you click on one of your targets and press F, so you can start moving again.
Well, one of the drones and press F.
Select one of the enemies, sorry, and press F. So basically, recommand them. My drones are deciding to do split fire, which is not helpful.
I'm so confused right now. Oh well.
Okay, I'm gonna scoop my drones and see which ones are left.
I didn't fit a micro warp drive.
I've already got an aspect on mine as well.
Yeah, I've got.
Yeah, I can see your little drones.
Yeah, it's just taken me forever to get to them to scoop them.
What have you told them to return?
I can't. Because it says I have no drones in local space.
That's weird. Aw, your drone's quite cute, really.
Apparently 60,000 discs have been added to a bounty payout.
Just about to say, where did those augmented warriors come from? I just realised.
Slowly scooping them all up.
Sorry?
So I'm slowly scooping all my drones up.
Yep, I can slowly see them disappearing from my overview.
Okay. Need to find two more. And there's one. And then there's the other. Okay, I have them all back.
Awesome.
I'm going to try scanning down a cosmic scanning a cosmic signature.
Cool.
I am going to do this so incorrectly wrong.
Well, probably not. This is the great thing, is the fact that we have multi-twitch, which means I can actually watch what you're doing.
So I've just launched 8 scanner probes.
Mm-hmm.
Now what?
So you need to bring up your probe scanner window.
I have that window open.
And then do you have the map open?
No.
Okay, so the button on the far right, solar system map.
Yeah.
So you should be able to see the 2 red spheres?
Yes.
Cool. So, I will actually launch my drones so I can properly follow along with this. Oh, there they are. I need to decloak. There we go. Now I can see what you're seeing too. So the transformation widget in the middle. Basically position it so the middle of it is over the middle, the X of the things in the middle. The things in the middle, that's really not helpful. So, there's an X in the middle of the red spheres.
Yeah.
You want to get your movement widget thing so the X is in the middle of your movement widget.
Okay, you're saying movement widget.
Ah, right, okay.
I know what those words mean.
Okay, so all those blue spheres that are your probes.
Okay.
So the one you're looking at now, I mean, I've got a whatever Twitch's standard delay is. So the blue things are your probes. At the moment, yours look like they're in pinpoint formation. You probably want to launch in the spread formation to start with.
Okay, yep, there's a lot more blue things now.
Yep. When the things you're trying to scan are, like, full red spheres, spread formation is going to be your best bet. When you get it down to kind of like a red circle, you can change it to pinpoint, because it's basically triangulating.
Okay.
So when it gets to a smaller area, you need, like, pinpoint can make triangulation easier.
Okay. Now what?
Okay, you still... Oh, you have got the movement widget in the middle. So the middle probe, the blue circle in the middle, you should have the kind of arrows in the box. The arrows in the cube. Yeah, there you go. I can see you moving it around. Bearing in mind I've got the Twitch delay at the minute.
Yeah.
So... position the middle of the cube over the red cross in the middle of one of the red spheres.
Okay.
And then hit analyze.
Okay, because when I was scanning before, I did nothing like this. Oh, yeah, I've scanned something down to 1.7%. I'm guessing you just continue to do that until the numbers go up a bit more?
Yep, just keep repositioning. Remember to do it in all three dimensions, so mine was a bit low down after scanning it a bit, so I'm kind of like, had to check it in all three dimensions, making sure it's the right way. Could probably go to pinpoint for the one I'm on at the minute. And also, on the spheres, if you click and drag one of the spheres, it's more important when you get into pinpoint formation. It will expand their radius. In fact, it'll do it in spread formation as well, I think.
Okay,
so... if you want to like reduce your radius a bit, you can just click and drag up on any part of one of the spheres, and it should make it smaller.
Okay, I think I'm doing this wrong.
Really?
Or at least this isn't making any sense. So the first scan, first time I scanned it went to 1.7%. Mm-hmm. Second scan, it went to 1.8%.
Mm-hmm.
Third scan, it's now gone from a sphere to a circle, but it's down to 1.7% again.
Okay. That's a bit strange. It may have been that slightly off in one of the three axes, maybe? Yeah, just keep at it. I mean, there's quite a lot of the time when they're really, really tricksy.
Yeah, now it's down to 1.3%.
Okay.
But...
okay, so it's gone to a circle, right?
You said? Yeah.
Okay, you can change to pinpoint formation now, if you like. But just keep doing the same thing, get the middle of the cube covering the centre of the thing that you're trying to scan, basically. If you're still really, really confused afterwards, I'm doing the exact same thing on my screen as well. So on the VOD, you'll be able to see what I was trying to explain. Really badly explaining how to scan.
No, what? Now it's gone down to 0%.
Okay, the radius on your pinpoint formation may have been a bit small.
4 AU?
Yeah, you may need to expand it a bit, because again, because it's all working on triangulation, you need to give it some room to get readings other than what it's trying to scan, basically.
Okay, I've bumped them up to 8. So, okay. Oh, jeez, go away. I guess part of my problem is, and this is just with 3D stuff in general, is, right, so I've got it so that the cube is over the X at the moment.
Yeah.
But then if I move the camera, it's no longer over the X.
So you're using left click and drag to rotate the camera, yeah?
Yeah. Although this time I seem to actually have it pretty much on. So that was a bad example, bad time to use that as an example.
Well, at least you've got it. Hopefully it'll work.
This is why I pretty much failed at 3D modelling in uni. And no, that was still 0.0%.
If it makes you feel any better, mine's just gone from something large percent to 0.0 as well. Are you having any more luck?
I'm just trying it again.
Which one are you scanning? Are you scanning DVM or MRV?
No. DVM. I think. It's the closest one.
It's also the one.
Oh, I've got it down to an absolute tiny, tiny, tiny dot.
Awesome. So yeah, just pinpoint formation and bring your range in. It does take a little bit of getting used to kind of go, oh, I can afford to shrink the range of the probes a little bit. That just comes with just practice and stuff. But
so, okay, so I was only looking at the signal percent, which is still 0.9%, but I've got it down to a tiny little dot now.
You having any more luck?
I think so. Possibly. I feel like I'm back in intro to 3D modelling.
Damn, three-dimensional space.
Yeah. Ooh, it's now back up to 1.5%.
Some of them are quite difficult to scan down. Well, like, I've only just got it to 1%, actually.
Okay, I've now got 2 DVM 725 signatures.
Yes, the best thing to do then is to put your probes at the midpoint between them. So put them so your probes are
halfway,
just covering both of them, because one of them will be a false positive, basically.
Nothing's ever easy, is it?
Nope. There is a reason.
Okay, I'm back down to one of them now.
A learning cliff rather than a learning curve. Well, I've only just managed to get it to 3%, so.
I thought I was doing well at 2.2%.
Still seems to be a bit of a.
Oh, 2.6%! So, okay, obviously the probes only last for a certain amount of time, don't they?
Yes.
What happens if it takes longer than the time remaining to scan this down?
I believe you essentially lose signal. You lose your connection to them. So...
Do you then have to start all over again?
Does not sound like a good O.
No, I had it at like 2.9%, then 2.3%. What percentage are you up to?
If I tell you, will it just make you depressed?
Pretty much.
Okay.
Please, tell me.
I'm more than you are.
19.5?
You're watching stream, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Although, to be honest, this is still taking me a lot longer than usual. So this is a tough one to scan down.
Yeah, I'm kind of tempted to just go try scanning the other one.
Yeah, the other one wasn't as tough as this one. I can tell you that.
Yeah, I think I might just go to the other one.
I'm going to finish scanning this one.
Why?
I've just got it to enough where I can tell what type of site it is.
What?
It's a data site. Shiny, shiny, hacky boot. Do you have any more questions for me, by the way?
Oh, yes.
Because we're getting close to needing to stop as well, and if you want to kill me to get your kill right, then I think once you scan down this anomaly, I will go D-ship or ship it to make you can easily blow up, and then you can kill me.
Yay! Okay, so next question. So, when people stop playing for, you know, a few months, a few weeks, however long, it's obviously, so your character and all your items still exist, they're just there waiting for you to resub.
Yeah.
Is there a time limit on that? So if, say, someone was playing, say, 8 years ago, and then for some reason or another stopped playing, is all this stuff still there?
I don't know the actual time limit, but I made a character in 2010, I think. Yeah, 2010, which no longer exists.
As okay.
There is no trace of her anymore at all. After a while, an inactive account. I can't remember if they did a cleanup at one point, which is why it was, and all inactive accounts that have been inactive for a certain amount of time were told, if you don't resub, we'll delete your account, basically. I didn't play Eve at the time. I wasn't interested in playing Eve at the time, so I was like, nah, I don't really care. Interestingly, they don't just go, okay, it's as if they never existed. Your character still exists in the database, but as whatever faction you are, citizen, number, blah, 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 blah. So somewhere out there is a character called Amar, citizen number, whatever, 1,700,000 and something, or whatever it was, I think it was. And that is my original character.
Mm-hmm.
So they kind of do, kind of don't. I think it's usually when they do, if they have to do a database cleanup or something.
And yeah.
You've got really old inactive accounts, give you one last chance to come back and then go, meh.
Okay. So it's not like, so I've seen a few people talk about how in a few years' time there's just going to be hundreds, if not thousands, of dead people on Facebook.
Yeah.
So it's not going to be a case of that.
Probably not. Although, yeah. Something I can tell you about, not on stream.
Okie doke. I have this thing scanned to 16% already.
Nice. Yeah, the one you were originally scanning, I can only get it to 86%.
Jeez.
And it is not moving from 86%.
Is that?
So it's
pretty. Oh, it's a combat site.
It is. Which means you've got it to a pretty high percentage.
28.
Nice. Reckon you can get that.
So I'm guessing once it gets to a certain percent, it goes yellow or orange.
Yeah.
Oh, it's gone back down to 22%.
Places like that just readjust your probes a little bit.
Yeah. So, next question.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, something's shooting me!
What?
That's not the question.
Something's shooting you?
Yes, Serpentis stuff.
Oh, rats.
Okay. Oh, I'm being targeted by someone, so I can't cloak. Ah! Drones! Launch!
I'm actually going to come and bring a logistic ship to your rescue, because I happen to have one from yesterday. This is actually the kind of things that used to happen when I lived in Lowestek. Occasionally we'd just be having a conversation on comms and then someone would go, I'm being shot! I'm like, right, whopping.
Yay, I killed something! Ah, no, don't orbit. Oh no, there's a battleship incoming. I have no hope.
It's fine, I've got guns on this thing too.
Yeah, the battleship's now the only thing remaining.
Oh, hello!
Hi.
Oh my god, you need reps.
Yep. Yes, I do.
Right, if you're not already moving, for god's sake, move.
I'm moving towards him.
Right, I'm going to rip your armour.
Thank you.
I'm going to shoot out of that battleship.
That's a yellow box, and it's also a good thing.
Why is it not hitting him?
Oh no, you're yellow boxing me, which is a good thing.
Yes, when I'm in a logistic ship, this is definitely a good thing. It means I'm saving your ass. Unfortunately, I can't repair your shields because my shield drones got destroyed yesterday.
Go on, drones. Go do your thing.
I don't do a whole lot of DPS in this, by the way.
It's better than the tiny fraction that I'm currently doing.
I don't know, I'm doing 30 damage per hit. That's kind of it. And he is a battleship.
Oh, this reminds me of the end of the Sisters of Eve arc.
Oh, the white slowly melting through shields.
Yeah. There's something else incoming. Another battleship. Oh no, that's the one I'm targeting. I'm an idiot.
That's the Ventus Port Admiral?
Yes. That's a nice ship, actually.
Which one?
What I'm shooting.
Oh, the Dominic's.
Oh my god, only halfway through the shields. What even?
Yeah. Do you know what's worse? It's usually armor tanked.
As we were so rudely interrupted, next question.
Okay.
This is a bit of a jokey question. So, obviously, according to various religious scriptures, Eden was supposed to be a nice, safe place. Until somebody decides to, you know, listen to a snake.
Yeah.
So why the name New Eden? Don't people know that it's a bad thing? And bad things will happen?
That's even more ironic is the fact that we're shooting a Serpentis at the moment.
I couldn't have timed that better to ask that particular question.
Are you being targeted by anything other than the battleship?
Battleship's not even targeting me.
Okay. Oh, cool.
I'm only being targeted by you.
There we go, battleship exploded.
Yay!
But I can take zero credit for that.
So, back to scanning. Where were we before we were so rudely interrupted? I'm so glad I cross questions out after I've finished asking them, because otherwise...
You're asking me the same ones again and again?
Yeah. Okay. Are you familiar with how drugs work in Fallout?
Yes.
So, are there any side effects like that to taking boosters in Eve?
They do have side effects. Because I don't use them very often, I can't tell you off the top of my head what they are, but there is a skill, which I think Ellie's actually got trained, let's have a look. There is a skill that reduces the side effects. If I can... their brain is giving up on me now. Neural enhancement. No. Okay, there's several things that, like, change what boosters do. There's a skill called Biology, which gives a bonus to attribute booster duration per skill level.
Okay.
But there is another one that reduces the side effects. And I thought I had it trained, and apparently I don't. I'm gonna look it up. There we go, neurotoxin control. Someone in chat knows far better than I do. So yes, there are side effects, and neurotoxin control is a skill you can train that lessens the side effects.
Okay. Oh yeah. Are there any scenarios in which someone can win a ship from a fight instead of just destroying it?
Only if the players specifically agree to that. There is no mechanic in the game in place for that.
Okay. Because that seems like quite a popular mechanic in various games, where you can shoot people so you'd end up killing the character but then still being able to loot all their stuff, including the ship.
But yeah, the only way you could do that is if you were in combat and you said, okay, just before I blow up your ship, when you say surrender, then I will take your ship and say that I've won.
So how would you get the ship from me if we did that, for example?
So you can leave a ship. So while you're in space, you can get out of the ship into your capsule.
Okay.
And then the ship is just a ship in space. And if you have the required skills to pilot that ship, you can, in a capsule, go up to that ship, jump in it, and fly off with it. Which is how people steal capital ships and things from pauses. If they are not actually inside the pause shields. It's also quite good in the Drifter fleet that we do as well. Obviously, there's a decent likelihood of being destroyed by a Drifter Doomsday. yeah. And we get new people every time I'm on a Drifter fleet. There's always new names, new faces and stuff. If they happen to die before they get to the nice little vault room and the pickup sticks room, it's kind of a shame because they're like two of the big things about Drifter hives. So quite often,
either the FC will say, does someone want to give this person a ship so they can see the final room, because you can't go into the final room just to capture.
Yeah.
I've done it a couple of times as well, just to say, I've seen the pickup sticks room, it's really cool, I want you to go see it, I will jump out of my ship, can you fly a scythe, is usually for me. Can you fly a scythe? Yep, here you go, have my ship.
Enjoy. Yeah, this Ganon is just not happening. I seem to be jumping between like 23% and 29%. Seems to be going no higher.
Right, do you want to blow me up, lady?
Yes.
I am going to go reship. I want to do one thing first and then you can kill me.
Okay.
But I will come back onto grid. And I think I'll be able to do that in this system.
Yeah, I'm just going to recover my probes and try again some other point.
So, while I'm reshipping,
yes.
You just want to stay where you are. If you look at the fleet window now, you will see there are some more names in there.
There are indeed.
They have brought an array of very nice ships for you to look at as well.
Ooh.
Including the alternative version of the Nyx.
Which one's that?
The Thanatos.
I'm currently looking at the Phoenix.
Kaldari. Dreadnought.
Oh, we don't like Kaldari though, do we?
Yeah, they're a bit too linear for me. I think that's why I like Galente, because it's quite curvy and spherical and cylindrical in places.
I do like the light animation at the back of the Phoenix though. That's quite mesmerising. I could watch that all day.
It's not the Phoenix, it's... Oh no, you'll be able to see it on the... There's a Wyvern in Fleet, actually. You'll be able to see it on that. The kind of... It's like a kind of like a shieldy type thing, which is where the fighters launch from.
Oh, at the back?
Directly down from that. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
That is pretty sweet.
It's the little detailed stuff like that that's really cool. Are you still listening to the stream, by the way?
No.
Okay, that's good.
Why?
I think you'll see.
Oh, that is a nice Thanatos.
I do like the Thanatos. I still prefer the Nyx, but the Thanatos is really cool.
I like the skin on it.
Is it blue?
Yeah, and the way the light seems to ripple across it. That is gorgeous.
I'm about to land back on grid with you guys anyway.
Okay.
There we go, I can see people now. Oh, I do kind of like the Moros as well. It's just another lumpy space potato, but it's quite a pretty lumpy space potato.
What are you flying?
I have the Kaldari rookie ship.
Ah.
There is a reason for the Kaldari rookie ship. And I don't think it's something you'll have picked up on. But
you're invulnerable.
What?
You're invulnerable.
Am I?
Oh, you're not anymore. That's fine.
Yeah. Don't shoot me yet.
I've just got you locked up.
Okay. Sorry, I'm just looking at the Thanatos going, ooh, pretty. Yeah, that's the Quake skin on the Thanatos, I believe.
Ah.
Yes, the Quake skin, which I really, really love. Sorry, I'm just looking around at all the ships in our fleet. Oh, lumpy space potato that is the Moros, but it's very, very pretty. It looks like a kind of space slug.
Well, aren't all ships space slugs?
This is true. Ooh! Ooh, I didn't realise there was the red skin on the phoenix. That is very pretty. That's cool.
Can I shoot you yet?
Nope.
Come down.
Yes, there is Method to the Madness. It is mentioned in an episode of Learning Cliff, but it's not something I think would have been important for you to listen to at the time. I only have one module in the ship.
Okay.
That's it. And it does this. And now in space you should be able to see exactly what that is.
A silent... Oh, that thing again!
What is it?
A sinusoidal field.
See, you've always been able to say that. It's fine. But yes, people make new characters just to use them as sinopilots for their big ships.
Okay.
So the reason you build Kaldari alts is because the Kaldari rookie ship doesn't need any cargo expanders to be able to fit the amount of liquid ozone. There we go. Amount of liquid ozone you need to generate a sino field.
Ah.
Kaldari rookie ship has the highest capacity of any of the rookie ships, I believe. So it doesn't take long to train into using just a basic Tech 1 sino. You get a rookie ship for free. Buy some liquid ozone off the market. You can jump capital ships anywhere you like. Well, low second, not second.
Yeah.
I think they've changed the sino field effect since I last saw it, actually. That is very pretty.
Yeah.
Slightly hypnotic.
Yeah, quite mesmerising again.
Okay, the thing now is, I'm also locked in place. I cannot move until my sino field goes down, which is, I think, 5 minutes.
Is anything bad going to happen to me if I accidentally fly through the sinusoidal field?
No, because it's like a wormhole. You have to right-click on it and choose to jump through the field, basically.
Okay. Why are you so far away? Oh my gosh.
I'm 70 kilometers away.
I think I'm almost out of questions.
Really?
Yeah. Well, there's...
For now.
For now, yeah. Well, there's two, possibly three more.
Any more just randomly off the top of your head while we're sitting here staring at Sino Field?
Why did I not fit a bloody micro warp drive to this ship? Don't think that's when you can actually answer there, is it?
The same reason that I didn't on my Aneris. Because I forgot and I'm an idiot.
Yeah. So how many I guess features, I guess is the word to use, that we may have encountered this evening that are not currently over on Tranquility, how many do you reckon actually make it over there?
I believe like 95% of them.
Hmm.
Because Singularity is a public test server.
Yeah.
This is kind of like the last stress testing and like everybody plays the game differently kind of testing.
Yeah. Play testing.
They obviously do internal testing and they've got Duality, which is a closed test server, which they can do some stuff on as well. So by the time it gets to Sissy, it's usually gone through internal QA, Duality, which is like they do cross-continental QA and stuff. By the time it gets here, it's like, okay, this is kind of almost feature complete. We just need to do some tweaking and stuff. So I can't really think of anything off the top of my head that's been on Sissy that hasn't hit TQ. You may want to look at the Sino field shortly, I believe.
I've just started. Oh no. Why haven't they started hitting you yet? Oh, what? That's pretty cool.
What happens is it takes a sign of you. Ooh, target painter burst. That is pretty. Oh no, Cali, oh, I'm being target painted. Oh yeah, the target painted burst. Oh, that's gonna help you kill me a lot faster.
Yay!
Oh, it's been a long time since I heard my hull alarm. Ah! Haha!
Yay!
You didn't activate my kill, right?
Yeah, because I've not killed you yet, I've just killed your ship.
Okay, kill me. But I'm not sure if you have to activate the kill right on me first.
Oh, okay.
I'm not 100% sure.
Kill right. Nope.
Okay.
The only options I have are make available to everyone, make available to my corporation, make available to my alliance, or make available to dot dot dot.
Just kill me then. Please scoop my wreck, because the Sino field and the leftover liquid ozone both dropped. I know it's only 100 disc, but meh. Can't believe I'm about to be podded by an Astero. That's the tagline for this whole stream. These are all the big ships we've got sitting around us. I mean, it's surrounded by a Thanatos of Phoenix and Moros of Wyvern, and I'm being killed by an Astero with Tech 1 drones. I love this game.
Oh, the kill right is still active. What? Why?
Clone activated. And I have no pod.
I am so confused.
Yeah, the chat makes a good point. You can scoop my corpse as well.
Where's your corpse? Where's your corpse? Where's the corpse?
Someone else might have grabbed it? I don't know.
What type of thing is a corpse?
It's called biomass. If you're looking to make sure if it's on your overview or not.
It was not on my overview.
It's not by default.
Scoop to cargo hold. I finally have a corpse!
Well, we will now have to end the stream here because I cannot jump back to that station.
Whoops.
Because I have a log off timer, I cannot jump back.
Really?
Yeah. I can't use the move me command until my log off timer has expired, which is in 13 minutes 14 seconds.
Damn. What should I do with your corpse?
I don't want to know what you're planning to do with my corpse.
I think I might sell it.
No one will want it.
I'm gonna dock up and sell your corpse. We're being asked to stream some more.
Yeah, I've just read that too. I need to think of stuff to do.
There's plenty of stuff we can do.
Oh god, it means I'm going to have another conversation that starts with you going, I may have 3 pages of questions for you.
It was 5 pages, actually.
Oh, guilt.
And that wasn't so bad, was it?
No. I think I didn't screw up answers to any except 2 of them.
Right, how do I sell stuff?
I don't think you can sell my corpse. You can trade it.
I can add it. What's add to market quick bar?
That's a quick bar is kind of like a quick way to search between things, I think. So if you're looking for I need this, this, and this. If it's things you buy regularly, you can just go, oh, this, this, and this.
I know what I'm going to do.
Oh, God. What are you going to do?
Nothing. Nothing you need to know about.
Is this revenge for me getting you killed in Head GP?
No.
Okay.
Oh, I can't remember how to do something, but if I ask you how to do it, you'll know what I'm doing.
Okay, do you want to know the sneaky way to do it? I will leave Fleet. And then in Fleet Chat, you can ask one of them. And that way, I won't see.
Yeah, but you'll just be watching the stream and be like,
watch
sneaky.
My own stream. I'm talking to chat. I'm being sociable.
No, I'm going to see if I can remember how to do this, because this is something I've done before.
God, now I'm worried.
How did I do this? Unless I just can't. Oh, what? Oh, that is some actual bullshit.
What now?
I was gonna just contract your corpse back to you. I can't see, and oh, because it's still in my ship.
Yes.
It
has to be in a hangar in the station.
But now I've told you what I'm going to do. Oh well. There you go.
What are you giggling at?
There's just a contract waiting for you.
Oh god. The contract corpse female has been assigned to you.
Yeah, read the rest of it. Just the fact that I'm making you pay for your own corpse?
You're making me pay oh god. I now regret telling you that everything costs 100 isks. Oh god. Fine, I will pay 100 isks to get to my corpse back. in a station that I cannot access for another 7 minutes 23 seconds.
I take it would be longer to manually fly here.
I'm the other side of New Eden. Yeah. Anyway, I think I'm gonna wrap it up here.
Yeah. That was fun.
It was pretty good. So, thank you everybody in chat who was watching, and especially to those guys who came out and flew ships with us and shot at us. And not the guy who randomly killed your Asteria.
No.
I don't know that guy.
No.
That was less fun considering he'd only just finished fitting it.
I suppose that guy wasn't to know that, I guess.
No. But yeah, it's my friend, guys, no doubt. Something will come up and we'll end up streaming again. You're still giggling like a maniac and it's still terrifying me.
Right, so I've killed you, but I've still got the kill right active. How is that even a thing?
I did even read up on kill writs earlier as well, and I can't remember. My brain is shut down.
Fine, I'm just going to have to find you in the next 5 days or something and kill you.
You can try.
Or, just wait till it expires, set up a trap so you end up killing me again when you really shouldn't, and then boom, new kill right.
You really expect me to fall for that again?
I think you know you will.
Your safety's a green. Can't shoot you. I've learned.
It's not like I'd survive. It's not like I'd survive long enough in high sec for you to, you know, kill me anyway.
This is true. Anyway, thank you and good night, everybody.
Thank you.
And I think we have an answer. You need to activate the kill rope, but you can't do it in 00.
So wait, so if I come to you... Oh, but I've already killed you. Oh.
Well, you... Good luck trying to get to where I am right now, because I am in 1.0 high sec. That is not on the move me command.
Well, then.
Anyway, thank you, and good night, everybody.
Good night, and goodbye. Not forever. That would be weird. But good night.